It's popping and sizzling, steaming and burning. The young museum visitors are watching the spectacle in fascination. They're in a lecture hall, but not just any lecture hall. This is the historic lecture hall of one of Germany's best-known chemists, Justus von Liebig.
What you've been looking at is the world's first chemistry lecture hall, which was created without any previous model whatsoever. The entire design of the lecture hall, for example the ventilation system, the pull-down blackboard, and the fact that the preparations for the lecture are carried out in a laboratory behind the hall, all of these things you can still find today in every modern chemical lecture hall around the world.
This historic construction can be found here in Giessen, Germany. The man who helped to ensure its preservation was Heinrich Emanuel Merck, the founder of the Merck company. Chemistry was not the only bond connecting him with Justus von Liebig. Documents from that period prove that the two men were friends. It was a friendship that extended beyond their deaths and was continued by the two families.
Of course, there were also personal relationships. For example, one of Liebig's sons did an apprenticeship as a pharmacist at Merck, and a grandson of Merck was a student of Liebig's. But I think those things were secondary. The fact that the Merck company remembers where the real source was, how the pharmacy became an industrial company, and that it has very gratefully continued along this path. That's a very fortunate thing for us.
In
1910, the Merck company presented this historic lecture hall to the Museum Association of Giessen. On the original benches, you can still see the traces of Liebig's first students.
Students used to scrape their feet, and if you look closely, you can see that the wooden footrests are worn down, but they are still the original footrests. That means the students were satisfied with the lectures.
In this lecture hall, the retired teacher Eberhard Theophil is to give lectures accompanied by experiments that will get audiences both young and old excited about the natural sciences.
And the man who designed it was Justus Liebig. We have far more than 100 registrations per year from school groups wanting to come here. This is where they can experience chemistry in a concentrated form, in ways that school teachers cannot offer. And they can realize how interesting chemistry can be.
This is why everyone is allowed to take a look behind the scenes during these presentations. While the older students are busily carrying out experiments in the laboratory, the youngest ones are eating soup in an adjacent room. Soup they have cooked themselves, of course.
I would keep that.
Well, did it taste good?
It needs some salt.
In the meantime, loud sounds of explosions are coming from the lecture hall. Theophil, the experimenter, is completely in his element.
The bill has to be completely wet. Then you briefly hold it underneath, just until it begins to burn. You can hardly see the flame, but it's there. You make it fun. You get reactions. I'm trying to communicate with the audience. When you realize they're getting the point, the effect becomes even stronger. I'm actually enjoying my retirement, even though it involves a lot of work. But it's really fun.
The spirit of Justus von Liebig is still filling the rows of the lecture hall even after some 140 years. And who knows, perhaps one of these future researchers will soon be following in the footsteps of the great master.